After Obi-Wan Kenobi took Anakin as his apprentice, Palpatine started taking great interest into the development and training of young Skywalker, constantly advising Anakin and swaying him to his inevitable future. However, during that period between Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones, an assassination attempt on the Chancellor and the Senate would come as quite the shock to the Jedi. The event is thoroughly explained in the Jedi Quest novels, more specifically The False Peace. It eventually explains how both Obi-Wan and Anakin discover a secret facility, one where the deranged scientist Zan Arbor had developed a drug called the Zone of Self-Containment. Upon discovery, she was forced to destroy the facility and flee. However, the drug was to be used for other purposes. Soon thereafter, the famed persecutor for the Galactic Senate, Sano Sauro, was working together with Granta Omega, the son of the fallen Jedi Xanatos. Together, they started to implement their plan to destroy the Jedi Order. Sauro began to make anti-Jedi accusations in order to dissolve the Galactic Senate's support of the Jedi Order. A vote was to be held in the Senate over whether or not the Jedi should be involved in Senate activities. This was all part of Omega's and Sauro's master scheme. By leaking Zan Arbor's drug, called the Zone of Self-Containment, into the ventilation shafts of the Senate, they would in fact successfully assassinate the present Supreme Chancellor Palpatine. Then, Sauro's supporters could easily garner him a seat as the new Supreme Chancellor of the Galactic Republic. This would also give Omega unlimited power in destroying the Jedi. However, thanks to the actions of Anakin Skywalker together with his master Obi-Wan Kenobi and Ferris Olin, this plot was soon discovered and stopped. Sauro managed to change sides at the last minute and vote for supporting the Jedi, therefore he went unscathed. What's more is that with Palpatine's mantra of keeping your enemies closer, he offered Sauro the position of Deputy Chancellor, which he of course accepted. Granta Omega, however, did not slip by so easily. He was tracked down by the Jedi to be in Korriban, and Obi-Wan Kenobi killed him in the end since he considered him to be too dangerous to be kept alive. Alright Star Wars fans, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you liked it, feel free to leave a thumbs up down below and subscribe if you haven't already, and don't miss out on any of my future videos that I will post on this channel. Have a fun day, my friends, and in closing, don't forget, may the Force be with you always.